The volar splint is an ideal application for wrist sprains, carpal tunnel syndrome, lacerations, and night splints. To begin, measure from the palmar crease to 2 finger widths distal to the antecubital. Then, cut the desired length of the splint and place the splint on the patient's arm. You can open the padding completely. If you use a bucket of water or faucet for water activation, you do not need to open it. Align the distal end of the splint with the angle of the palmar crease. Next, fold one edge of the splint over by following the palmar crease. Mark this line on the substrate. It is optional to also mark a line around the thumb area. Allow the patient to have more space at the antecubital part of the splint. Cut and trim the substrate there as well. Next, cut the marked parts. If the padding has been opened, it is optional to take the substrate out for this step. Place the substrate back into the padding, close it, and trim the overlapping padding, leaving a margin of padding on either side. If you cut a space for the thumb into the substrate, place some small cuts in the padding as well. Activate splint with water. Apply the splint on the patient's arm by positioning it towards the palmar crease. To secure the splint, wrap with a bandage distal to proximal. Anchor at the wrist and twice through the web space and around the thumb. Proceed up the arm with overlapping by 50% of the bandage and fixate the bandage with tape or a hook and loop fastener. Mold the splint inside the palm with your thumb or palm of hand. Use your thumb to hold the patient's thumb and place the patient's hand inside both of your hands until the splint is in a rigid position. Mold as prescribed by the physician.